What's good, YouTube? TV Lax here bringing you guys another video today. Yes, I'm down to my last 15 days of minoxidil. It's a little tricky to kind of really decipher how much progress there's been, so I'm gonna go to the dermatologist, see what's going on, get a little bit more clarity on what exactly is the cause of that spot, and what exactly we're gonna be doing to treat it moving forward. So if you're interested in that, come along.
You guys, it has been a very interesting couple weeks on YouTube. For the first time in a long time, like a long time, I'm actually really excited to edit these videos, to make them, to, you know, try new things. Earlier phase of creation, when y'all were seeing a lot of my videos, I was so stifled by, you know, the little time that I had, right? It was very difficult to prioritize or put much time into videos when you're worried about trying to make a living for your family. But now I don't have as much concern with that. You know, I'm making the living, we're making, you know, the money. We want more money, but we're making the money. And I can just really enjoy creation, you know? And now I can grow an audience of people who really wanna see everything that we put out, who love the personality, who love the family, and who wanna support, not people who just wanna hear me talk about hair. I can completely understand if that's all you want, but I gotta do more. So that's kinda where we at right now. Luckily for you today, we are talking about hair, okay? Right now, I am making breakfast for my baby girl. You know, that's my tradition. I wake up, I make breakfast, we'll do lunches. I also clean the kitchen, you know, real domestic life. All right, let me put this down. My wife, she did these cool little, let me show y'all, man. Yeah, my wife found this recipe on TikTok that created these cool little breakfast sandwiches. You know, I thought it was really cool that she, you know, came up with this little idea, this cute little paper that wrapped up and conveniently packaged for my daughter. I thought that was pretty cool. So, shout out to you, wife. Speaking of, you guys notice anything on the fridge? You guys notice anything on the fridge here?
Did you notice something?
I'm doing a promotional thing right now. I'm talking about this video right here that none of you went to go watch. They ought to be ashamed. Shouldn't they be ashamed?
Ashamed.
You've watched this little girl achieve her dreams? Ah, you're disgusting. Go watch the video.
Now, y'all, I ain't even gonna lie. I was a little flabbergasted seeing that video only had, like, what, less than 1,000 views right now? I could have sworn that when that video was gonna drop, it was gonna be this huge moment. It was gonna feel like my entire Locke family celebrating. But y'all was like, nah, bruh, it's just another Sunday, cuz I'm about to go watch Gunther. It's all good though. Right now, y'all watching me make breakfast for my baby. I really love, you know, this tradition in the morning. We get this opportunity to spend this time together, just have some dialogue. After this, I'm gonna go get ready for the bike.
While I'm on the bike, I'm gonna try to come up with some questions that I can ask the dermatologist. One thing that I absolutely hate is going to a dermatologist, any sort of professional, and not getting everything out that I really wanna know, especially when y'all are asking me follow-up questions. To make sure I check out those boxes, I absolutely have to think and prepare. You gotta take mental reps sometimes, right? Let me go ahead and do that. Just took my minoxidil, just drank my little morning protein shake. Let's get it popping. Come on in, office. All right, we got less than 10 minutes left. Just got done with the bike. Time is now 8:17. We need to be out here by 8:25. Come on, baby. No, I need you out the way, baby. I love you. Four-minute shower, 4 minutes left. The time is 8:24. I'm heading downstairs, putting on my Crocs. And I think we about ready.
Going out here looking like a runaway slave, boy, with his head in this patchy head in this sweat.
We's gonna be free.
Let us free.
I'm bald and patchy.
Okay, I'll stop it. See, I need to cool down. The dermatologist has agreed to sort of let me, well, he hasn't actually agreed, but the receptionist said that he'd be okay, so fingers crossed for that. I just want to be able to record myself while I'm asking him questions. while I was on the bike, I was preparing some questions for him. So what do you think it could have been caused by? Are we thinking it's male pattern baldness? What are the differences between male pattern baldness and the typical alopecia strand? It's right here.
I feel like a little middle school kid.
I'm in recess.
Tired. Now, you guys, I just wanted to show you proof that this is a dermatologist's office. This ain't the dentist. I'm not in here getting a physical. This is a dermatologist. He's about to come in here shortly. He wasn't actually comfortable with me recording, so I'm going to have to put a camera somewhere, like down here. Tuck that. The doc was kind enough to give me one little excerpt, so here it is coming up.
One of the biggest questions everyone is curious about, doc, is the potential cause. Like right now, I was thinking it's caused by the locks. Everyone wants to know if that's, you know, or is this just something that's, you know, par for the course, getting old?
Well, I don't know about the getting old part, okay. But I will say that a lot of my patients, their hair loss is multifactorial. Mm-hmm. So, and I don't think you're any different in that respect. You know, for sure you have the condition called seborrheic dermatitis, which creates this kind of flaky itchiness in your scalp. Right. And if you itch, you're going to scratch. If you don't scratch in the daytime, you scratch when you sleep. Mm-hmm. And if you scratch, you're going to lose hair.
That's true.
The good part about that type of hair loss, if there is a good part, is that if you can reverse that, you know, within a reasonable amount of time, the hair loss you get from that is not permanent.
Right.
And those hairs will start to come back in. And I do think your locks with traction, right? Mm-hmm. Especially with my patients I see who are generally older, right? Because your lock journey kind of takes a while to get the longer locks. But but regardless, it's the weight of the locks, right? Mm-hmm. After a while, they get so heavy, they start to pull down. And then the small locks can create more tension per se.
Mm-hmm.
But I think yours is multifactorial. I'm going to kind of approach each one of them differently.
Gotcha.
Okay. All right, you guys, I am back home now. Now, I couldn't get the entirety of the visit. The doctor was not completely comfortable with me having a camera in there, so didn't get all the footage. Essentially, what he told me is that there were two possible culprits for the type of alopecia I had. The two culprits are LPP and CCCA. CCCA is something that he actually feels fairly confident that he could bring back to full recovery. The LPP, not so much. In order to determine what kind of alopecia we have, my doctor did recommend a more aggressive regimen today. We're gonna be doubling the amount of minoxidil that we're gonna be taking, going from one half a tablet to a whole tablet. We're going to be adding in another drug that he gave me today, Visical Pro. Then he also recommended a topical. I told myself that I am going to be committed to his protocol. I receive a lot of recommendations from you guys every single day, and some things I am going to be adding to the regimen. Rosemary oil, that's one that I absolutely added. It's just literally sitting right here. A few other things that you guys have recommended that I'll try out. Microneedling. For now, I do want to trust this dermatologist. Well, he's a black man. He's somebody that I trust. He's somebody that I'm putting my trust in, and his practice has actually shown some great results for people of color all across Texas, so I absolutely want to make sure that I give him his credit once this is all over. And I'm gonna follow that protocol. So that's what we're gonna do for now. As of now, it seems like there's hope. You know, the two crossroads are, if it's the LPP, then I'm probably gonna stay bald. If it's the CCCA, then I could probably reverse some of it. This next 90 days is going to be make or break. So stay with me along my journey. I'll be giving you guys updates. All my funny, goofy content will stay as well. But I hope you guys follow along. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and this update. And TP Lots, signing out.